In the grim darkness of the far future, there is only war.
Hey, this is Chris at Talon Gaming. Today we're going to look at Warhammer 40,000 Battlesector, released in July of 2021. Developed by Black Lab Games and published by Slitherine Games, Battlesector is a turn-based strategy game featuring a 20-mission campaign as well as additional single and multiplayer game modes. It has the look and feel of a turn-based Dawn of War without any of the base-building mechanics. You play as Sergeant Carleon, leading the charge in an attempt to free your homeworld, Baal Secundus, from the Tyranid infestation. System requirements are very light. A mid-range CPU and GPU made in the last 5 or 6 years should more than suffice. You'll need a minimum of 4 gigs of RAM, 20 gigs of storage, and as always, check the video description for more detail. Let's look at some of the main aspects of Battlesector. Campaign play involves 20 storyline missions over a variety of terrain while freeing Baal Secundus from the Tyranid infestation. Skirmish play allows you to replay campaign missions and offers player versus AI gameplay using an army of your choosing on one of 8 unique maps, playing as either the Blood Angels or the Tyranids. You can play the death, use adjustable turn limits, or point targets. Multiplayer modes play similarly to the skirmish mode, but you can play live versus a human opponent over the internet. You can play with 2 people on the same PC in hot seat mode, or an asynchronous mode, which is essentially play by mail over the internet. You will need to log in for online play, either via Steam or a Slitherine account if you choose. The only difference here is that the Steam account doesn't provide email updates for play by mail. The game includes both a tutorial to help you familiarize yourself with the ins and outs of the game, a complete game manual in PDF form, and a screenshot tool that can be used to pause the game and take sweet action shots from any angle. The campaign features HQ upgrades, which allow you to spend upgrade points earned at the end of each mission. You'll be able to unlock new weapons and abilities and otherwise strengthen your units. Army management is where you'll build your army from the available unit and equipment types. While units themselves are free to purchase, each mission has a point capacity limit that all but the HQ units require for deployment. At the start of each mission, you'll see a mission briefing where you'll be presented with some backstory and HQ unit chatter based on the mission objectives. The reward unlock tokens for successful completion and the army size limits are also presented here. Next comes mission deployment, where you'll select from available units and upgrades and select their starting point within the area of deployment. Next comes the mission, where you'll need to complete mission objectives such as defending or assisting a friendly unit, clearing infestations, and a handful of other goals. And finally, once a mission is completed successfully, you'll see the mission debriefing consisting of some HQ unit chatter, reward and bonus objective tokens, and a summary of unit actions, kills, and losses.
Welcome to Baal Secundus, Sister Superior.
Let's have a look at combat. The game uses a simple square grid layout to navigate, using movement points that help to control the pace of the game and limit the number of squares a unit's able to move. Action points are required to attack and use most abilities, with the majority of units only being able to use a single action point per turn. Elite and HQ units have been given 2. Speaking of HQ and elite units, they're single standalone units that have special abilities such as healing, repairing, or buffing other units. They have many more hit points than regular squads and are equipped with more powerful weaponry. HQ units in particular can often turn the tide of the battle, and their deaths result in a mission failure. Mechanized units such as tanks, landspeeders, and dreadnoughts are a formidable force during combat. They have a wide assortment of available weaponry, heavy armor, expanded view cones, and can effectively deal with a variety of opponents.
Always forwards!
Infantry units vary from assault squads that can use jetpacks, pistols, and chainsaws, to units like hellblasters and intercessors that can strike from long range, as well as a variety of other unit types. Attack and damage types range from physical melee weapons such as power and chainswords, projectile and energy weapons, and even flamethrowers. The game features a fog of war system that only applies to hostile forces, as the terrain layout is completely available from the get-go, but enemies are only detectable within the cone of visibility of your units and by sounds in the distance.
The enemy waits for us.
Momentum is a mechanic that allows a unit to gain traction with every attack until it reaches 100 points, where it then can use a more powerful version of a current ability or gain an additional action point. It encourages you to move forward instead of falling back. Units will often defend themselves as they're being attacked or when an opposing unit travels too close or even attack in a retaliatory manner. If you use an action point to activate Overwatch, a unit will also attempt to cut down any foe that travels within the reach of its weapons. Tyranid types and attacks vary significantly, from small squads that can jump to attack, elite units that can shred armor, to much larger creatures that are able to vaporize an entire squad with a single shot. There isn't anything groundbreaking in Battle Sector when it comes to graphics, but what you do get is clear, crisp textures with plenty of detail for those of us who care more about gameplay than graphics. That being said, the game does look quite nice, offering very nice shadows and leaving trails of blood and carnage. Animations found in the game are very well done and suit the characters of the game nicely. Cutscenes are pretty well non-existent. What you'll find instead are still images depicting the story being told by voiced-over narrations. Sound effects are pretty good and fit the game very well, however there is a distinct lack of variety for each type of effect. Music is very good and fits within the theme of the game rather well, and voice acting for the most part is quite good.
I did not relish the thought of reporting your death to the Red
Council. You get the standard mechanized voicing found in many other 40k games with a fair bit of variety, and most of the actors seem to do the characters justice.
I am the Imperium's shield.
There are a few, however, that feel like they're a bit too much. The Death Company characters in particular sound harsh and are far too repetitive.
I will slay them all!
I quite enjoyed the story the campaign brought to the table. The tale of Sergeant Carleon attempting to free his homeworld of the Tyranid infestation and all of the other HQ characters' side stories were quite interesting. I wouldn't say that the story is extremely deep, but it does feel well laid out and progresses nicely throughout the game. The game features a simple but very effective user interface that lets you see and explore the landscape with minimal fuss. You can navigate the game with the mouse or the WSAD key, zoom out to a bird's eye view, rotate the screen around to any angle, and then zoom right back in to be up close and personal. The easy-to-use interface displays objectives, character details, and actions all laid out in a simple and easy-to-understand manner. Well done! The game also features a variety of difficulty levels but can be completely tweaked to suit your own tastes, allowing for any number of challenging combinations. The 20 mission campaign offers between 20 and 30 hours of game time, with each mission taking roughly an hour to complete. Taking any of the other game modes will really help you get the most for your money, and I also have to say that I really like the asynchronous play-by-mail game mode. That was a really great touch. All in all, I really enjoyed Battle Sector. The story, the gameplay, graphics, and sound were all well executed, made for great turn-based strategy gaming. Fans of Warhammer 40,000 or of turn-based strategies without any bloated base-building mechanics will surely enjoy this one. As always, thanks so much for watching to this point in the video. Like, comment, and please consider subscribing for more content just like this. This is Chris from Talon Gaming, signing out.